My buddy Tommy Byrne has made guitars for a long time, and I've made guitars too. He's often joked that if we ever make guitars together, then we could call them Burns & Noble after the well-known American bookseller. Tommy made me one of his guitars and, as a surprise, inlaid my surname in the pickguard and had a one-off Burns & Noble inlay placed in the headstock. These days I'm more focused on making amplifiers than guitars, so I thought it would be a great idea to do a demo of Tommy's guitar played through one of my amps. The BJ Byrne Apollo guitar is a single cut, solid electric guitar, similar in format to a Les Paul, with a stop bar tailpiece, a tune-o-matic bridge and two humbuckers. However, it's got a bolt-on neck and a 25.5-inch scale length, which is more like a Fender Strat. The 22 fret neck is a comfortable C-shape, and it weighs in at just 7 pounds and 12 ounces. With chrome-plated parts, this particular guitar has been equipped with two bare-knuckle Rebel Yell pickups, and has a selector switch together with a volume and tone control for each pickup, like a Les Paul. It has a black ebony fingerboard and pickguard. I think that the colour is just fantastic. It's really comfortable to play and it's great sounding. I'm just delighted with the guitar. The amp used is one that I've built from scratch and is based on the two-stroke design in Dave Hunter's book, The Guitar Amp Handbook. The two-stroke is based on the 1950s 5F28 Tweed Fender Princeton, but it has some additional features. The switchable boost, which gives different amp voicings, is particularly useful. The voicings are a Blackface era Fender, a Tweed era Fender, and a Marshall Plexi. It's a single-ended cathode bias amp, which is great for home recording. Dave Hunter's design is for a combo incorporating a Fender Tweed style chassis, but I wanted to have a Marshall style head that I can use with a variety of cabinets. The beauty of the two-stroke design is that it allows you to experiment with different rectifier, preamp and output tubes. For this demo, the amp is equipped with a 5Y3 rectifier tube, a 12AX7 preamp tube and a KT66 output tube. The custom-made speaker cabinet houses a 12-inch Celestian greenback that I bought new in the 1970s. No overdrive or distortion pedals were used to make this video. Any distortion that you hear is coming from the amp itself. On the complete track at the end, some post-production processing has been used. Here's the guitar and amp played in a variety of modes. As the guitar is equipped with pickups called Rebel Yells, it seemed appropriate to play out with something suitably raucous.